Waka 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 waka.
While the mat pairs away, the KM will play. Hey guys, welcome back to 52 Hookah. I'm your host Pac-Man, and today I want to talk about Adalya Love 66. Now, Love 66 is a very popular flavor, especially here in Australia. I don't know why, but everyone loves this flavor. And I wanted to pick it up and give it a shot. I've played around with it quite a lot to figure out what's the best way to heat manage it, and honestly, I've made more mistakes than I should have. But let me tell you exactly what I've learned, and you guys should be sailing with Adalya from start to finish after this video. So Love 66 is a passion fruit and watermelon flavor, which is actually very interesting because it's very passion fruit heavy, but I didn't really realize it was watermelon until someone told me that it was actually watermelon. Thanks, Gab. If it wasn't for you telling me that it was watermelon, I would not have picked up on that at all. But now I can taste it. But yeah, so it's a very cooling flavor, actually. So Love 66 is passion fruit heavy. It finishes off with a little bit of watermelon, and it is super mega cooling. So you don't want to put too much heat on because you'll get a lot of that cooling, and you basically just burn through the flavor very fast. Adalya, from my understanding, is not as heat resistant as nakhla. So I was initially cooking my Adalya the way I would with nakhla. I would put 3 cubes in my provost and just smoke it from start to finish. However, say if I packed 16 grams of Adalya and I used 3 cubes, after about an hour and a half, where I normally think that I could push it for 2 hours, I'd end up getting a headache. And eventually I decided to drop it down to 2 cubes, 25mm cubes, and that would get me all the way through to 1 hour, and then I'd top it up with a smaller cube, either like a cubette or another 25mm cube that I'd lit and just left in my cold tray, and that would push me forward that extra half an hour, maybe 40 minutes. Adalya cannot if you're packing 16 grams of Adalya, it is very difficult to get it to go past 1.5 hours. You may be able to get it through to 2 hours, but I recommend keeping it around 1.5 hours, hour and 40 minutes at most. Now, passively, you're not really going to get much flavor from Adalya, but an active exhale gives you that kick of the passion fruit and the watermelon. It's a very nice, simple flavor if you just want to have something to smoke and not want to think too much about the flavor complexity. Now, Adalya is also very cloud heavy. It's very plumy. You're going to get thick clouds from start to finish. Typically, I pack 16 grams of Adalya in my larger bowls, the ones that are normally about 76mm diameter. But today, for the sake of the review, I'm using my smaller Apache medium, and I've got about 10, maybe 11 grams of Adalya packed in here. In the provost, I've got 3 Shaman cubettes, and that is perfect just to get the heat up there. And I think I'll be able to get a good 1 hour session out of this, maybe a little bit more, but 1 hour completely without any problems. Adalya is a little bit buzzy, so keep that in mind. Typical of your more traditional brands of tobacco, like nakhla, like alfakar, they are a bit buzzy, so be careful in that respect. Adalya is a good mixer. I've mixed it with a couple of other blonde leaves. I've mixed it with pan. Adalya, Love 66, and pan go really, really well together if you want more cooling and a bit of that spice mixed in with the passion fruit. Totally a recommended mix, maybe about 20% pan, 80% Adalya, Love 66, and you're good to go. Definitely try Adalya Love 66 out. The more I smoke it, the more I realize it's actually a very pleasant flavor, and it's very nice and very simple. Now, enough about the Adalya. The second part of my video today, I want to talk about the KM. So the KM is back out after a long hiatus because I'm deep cleaning my matte pair. Interestingly, I wanted to try the KM using the MacPairs decanter base. And I've also picked up one of those silicon diffusers that you could slip onto a matte pair or onto a traditional hookah. Now I've got a diffuser pushed all the way up over the bell of the KM, and I've got the water level in the decanter base. You can't see, unfortunately. I'll put a picture up here. But yes, the water level is just over the bell and the diffuser. And what I find really interesting about this is that the session is very, very much improved. My KM is 10 years old. My closest friend, my best bro, bought it when he bought it in 2011, I believe, and I bought it off of him in 2017. So it is older. The purge valve is older. It is a very restricted purge. It takes 2 half breaths to really purge everything out completely. It is very different to the newer KMs, which have a more open purge, and it's actually a lot easier to purge with the newer KMs compared to this old boy. But no, when I've connected the KM to the decanter base with the diffuser, my sessions are actually a lot more open and very quiet. I've done the same thing with the KM base, but for some reason this particular hookah is still very restricted in the KM base with the diffuser, and I don't understand why, because it's really open, just noisy when it's on its own in the KM base. But when I threw the diffuser on, I must have screwed up the water level, but it was a horrible, horrible session. I do appreciate though that the decanter base is a complete 180 on that. Like, it is so much more open, it is so much quieter, and it is a very pleasurable smoke. It's almost comparable to the matte pair, but not quite. It's still good. There's still a level. There's still a bit more pull you need because it's not as open as the matte pair. But if you're on a budget, definitely use a KM with a diffuser and a decanter base, and you would have majorly improved sessions from there on out. So there you have it, guys. That is my take on Adalya Love 66 and my recommendation to try a KM using a decanter base. You guys should really give that a shot. It's actually really, really cool and a much improved session compared to what I've had with this thing in the past. All right, you all have a good one. I'll see you guys soon. Take care and stay safe.